So, the first part in this installation is you reboot to your recovery. If you have old TWRP or 3.0.2 version, please install this TWRP image before flashing this ROM. The link of this TWRP image will be given below in the description. You select this image file from old TWRP. Click on install image, select TWRP image and click on recovery and swipe to confirm flash. The TWRP 3.1.1 will be installed. You have to just reboot to your recovery again. So after booting in the TWRP, you have to wipe Dalvik, advanced wipe Dalvik system cache and data. Swipe to wipe. So after wiping, go back, click on install. Select the installation zip file of the ROM. After selecting the ROM file, swipe to confirm flash. Then Aroma installer will be opening. As you can see here, Aroma installer has been opened up. Now it will tell you the version number. Click on agree, click on next. If you want to upgrade, you can select upgrade. I will install here for a clean installation. It is an initial build. Click on next. If you want root, you can flash SuperAC or Magix, and you can install MIUI camera also. You can enable camera to API and enable fingerprint selfie if you want. Click on install AOSVP. The system will be flashed. It will take around 2 to 3 minutes. And a huge shout out to the developer for making this ROM. More stable builds of Oreo will be coming on my channel, so please subscribe. As you can see, ROM has been installed now. Click on next. It will say successfully installed. Click on finish. You will boot into TWR again. First you have to boot into system before flashing gapps or it will get boot loop. So I will be, it is saying no is installed, still you have to reboot. Then after booting, as you can see, ROM is booting up. AOSPVP security patch is of 5th August. It has got customizing features. Fingerprint is also working fine, no issues in that. Battery life is not tested yet, but we'll be testing soon. Wi-Fi and hotspot are working. No extra extra apps are installed. Volte is not supported yet. No, it is not stable yet. Camera stuck for 1 minute, then gives error. It's not responding, but boots up later.